Hello everyone, today we're going to be working on Project 3 in Dreamweaver and we're going to be using advanced layouts and CSS this time. So popping up in Dreamweaver, let's hit File, New. Let's create a blank page, page type HTML, and the layout here, we have a lot of options. So let me explain some of the differences and options here. Not only do you have a difference in how many columns the layout's going to be, but you also have a difference between these liquid and fixed. The liquid columns will be flexible. You can see that here they're represented by a spring and a percent sign. So these will adjust to the size of the browser window that you're viewing them in. And vice versa, fixed is all the dimensions of your layout is absolutely fixed. They will not adjust. If you make the browser smaller, you'll have to scroll around the image. You have to scroll around the page, rather. There's differences between the two, and I encourage you to try them both, because it all depends on what your design is and what your design goals are. So for right now, I'm going to pick three-column liquid. And before we're done, we have to specify the CSS. So layout CSS, we're going to have that say create new file. What that does is it puts the CSS, which I'll explain in a minute, in its own separate file instead of in the head of the document. And I'll show you why that's a great idea in just a minute. So once we hit Create, it'll ask us what we want to name that CSS file. And a three-column liquid.css, that's fine. We'll just save it like that. You could change yours to whatever you would remember. Remember, no special characters or spaces. So, I know caps as well, but that's just default. This is just for instruction. So, let's begin. So, this is a basic layout. It's full of instructions and text. You can, of course, you want to delete these and put in your own text. It's got some links already set up for us, which is rather nice. And you can see it's got some real style to it. It's not a basic web page. And if we view it in split view, you can see why. So this just looks like HTML, looks like any old regular HTML. A bunch of text in it, it's a fair amount of stuff, but you've seen this before. But the reason why things are the way they are is because up here in the head we've referenced that CSS file that we've created. Right now it's an absolute link to my hard drive because I haven't saved this file yet. Let's go ahead and do that first. File, save as. We're going to call this project3.html. So now we have our project 3 saved and you can see the link has changed. Now it is a link, it is a relative link because the CSS is in the same folder as this document. It needs just to put the name there and the browser knows where to look. So now you could start editing your page now. You could start putting in project 3, my project, whatever you want to call it. You can start editing the layout, you can get rid of this, you can start changing the names, page 1, make this a link. You know, all the things that you know how to do already. But that won't change how the page looks. It'll be this blue with black and white thing. To change how the page looks, we gotta edit the CSS file we created. And that's accessible up here, next to source code. There's also a link to the CSS. And if I go to split view for this, click on that, and here is CSS. You can see it's heavily commented, so take a look at these and read what these are. These aren't part of the code. You could delete these and be just as fine. But Adobe puts them in there to help you understand these layouts a little better. But what CSS does is it defines the style for HTML elements. So you can see here body, we know what body is, that's the body of the HTML page where all our content goes. And you can see that it defines a couple of things. It says that the font in the body is going to be these fonts here. The background is going to be this color, which is this dark blue. It's not going to have a margin, there's going to be no padding. And the text color is going to be black, that's code for black. In fact, we could change that and watch this. If we change the color to something else, and we hit refresh up here or on the right here, we've suddenly changed the color of the HTML text, or the text on our page rather, to be red. And that's pretty cool. That was pretty easy. Let's change the background now. Refresh. Ah, the background's black. Perfect. So let's give this a save. And let's give our HTML a save. And now I'm going to show you why this is great. I'm going to create a new document. And this will be our Project 3, page 1. In fact, let me change this real quick. P3, page 1. Perfect. So now we have a link to this, and we're going to create it. So go to File, New. And I'm going to make it one column, two column fixed left sidebar. How about that? The layout CSS, instead of creating a new file, we're going to link to an existing file. And you click this little chain down here, hit Browse, and let's find our CSS. Here it is. Choose that one. It's going to give us a warning about the path to the CSS file because it doesn't know where we're saving our HTML file yet. It's going to use an absolute path to the CSS, but when we finally save this document, it'll make a relative path, so that's okay. It's just giving us a warning. Hit OK, perfect, and then create. So you can see already, here is our new page. It's two column, don't mind this dotted line here, that's not part of a column. And you can see we've already got that red text and that black background. In fact, let's save this as first P3 project1.html. Perfect. And now if we change the CSS, how about a red background and black text? You can see that this page has changed, not just this page. Also, our first page has changed. And so this is highly configurable. You can see there's a lot of things in this CSS layout that you can mess with, that you can change around, that you can add, that you can delete. It's all up to you. And if you don't know what you're doing, just pop up a W3 Schools and look it up. Let's say I want to change, what do I want to change? Let's say I want to change the container, which in our code, in our source code rather, the container is the div tag, the dividing tag that contains the entire page. You can see there's the opening here, and there's the full body, and here's our closing. They even put a nice little comment there, end container. That's very nice of them. So let's change our container. Let's say we don't want it to be 80% width. We want our image to be 90% width. Or not image, we want our page rather. So watch me refresh. Watch this gap here in red. Boom. We just suddenly gained a little space on our page. And it actually works for both of our pages. See, they both. They both change. And that's the power of CSS. That's really why we use it. Because instead of having to edit every single HTML file, because you can put CSS in the head of an HTML file, and it will work. But this way, we can edit one single file and change the look of our entire website. Every page that links to the CSS inherits these properties. And it saves us a ton of time. I hope you use this to your advantage. You create really unique looking pages, and you'll see that CSS is a little different, but it's definitely very powerful, and it wants to be your friend. Will you let it? Thank you very much.